Very good morning to all of you. Welcome to Narayana online classes. Today I am going to discuss 10th class chemistry assignment. Assignment number 9. Topic is the chemical bonding. In which the first one is write the units of bond energy. The bond energy which is calculated in the units of angstrom units, nanometers and picometers. So here we can write the units of bond energy. Angstrom units, nanometers, picometers. One angstrom unit equal to 10⁻¹ centimeters, 10⁻¹ meters, 0.1 nanometers, 100 picometers. One nanometer equal to 10⁻¹ centimeters, 10⁻¹ meters. So the units of the bond energy is angstrom units, nanometers and picometers. Next, coming to second one, what is covalency? Covalency means the total number of the covalent bonds can form an atom of an element is called as a covalency. So the total number of covalent bonds form an atom of element. For example, here we take the hydrogen. Hydrogen H and H. Here how many bonds are there between the two hydrogen atoms? One bond is present. So the covalency of hydrogen is 1. Similarly, O2. Here how many covalent bonds are present between the two oxygen atoms? So 2 covalent bonds. So here the covalency of oxygen is 2. Next, coming to third one, explain the drawbacks of electron theory of valence. First here we have to again remember the chemical bonding in which covalent bond. What is the covalent bond? The pairing and sharing of electrons between the two atoms, then the resultant bond is called as a covalent bond. Here generally the bond energy or bond length for between any two atoms expected to be same. For example, the two atoms which are involved in the covalent bond. So here the bond energy and bond length of the atoms expected to be same. Because between the two atoms, the electrons are paired and shared. By the two atoms, then we can say the bond length and bond energy of the every molecule is same. But by experimental values, the bond length and bond energies are not equal. Bond length and bond energies are not equal. And here electron theory of valency main drawback is did not explain the bond angle of the molecule and shape of the molecule. For example, the bond angle of the BeCl2 180 degrees, BF3 120 degrees, CH4 109 degrees 28 minutes. These bond angles did not explain the electron theory of valency. So here simply we can write the drawbacks of the electron theory of valency. First one, did not explain the bond angle of the molecule comma shape of the molecule. These are the drawbacks of electron theory of valence. Next, coming to fourth one, represent the molecule H2O using Lewis notation. They are asking the Lewis notation for water molecule. Here, water, H2O means water, in which hydrogen atomic number 1, electronic configuration 1s1. Next, oxygen atomic number 8, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Here, oxygen is the central atom which is containing the 6 valency electrons, in which the 2s orbital containing pair of electrons and there are 3 p orbitals in p, in which the px orbital containing the pair of electrons, py and pz orbitals containing the unpaired electrons. So here if we draw the Lewis notation for oxygen, here pair of electrons, here one more pair of electrons, here two unpaired electrons. Next, for hydrogen, 1s1, one valency electron. Here two hydrogens are there. Here one hydrogen, here one hydrogen. So the bond is formed between this oxygen and hydrogen, So we can draw like this. This is the Lewis notation for water molecule. Next, coming to fifth one. So here, how bond energies and bond length of molecule help us in predicting their chemical properties? Explain with example. What they're asking? The bond length and bond energy, how it is useful to predict the chemical properties of the molecule with the example. Before that, we have to know about the what is the bond energy and what is the bond length. Bond length means the equilibrium distance between the nucleus of the two atoms which are held in covalent bond. That is called as a bond length. Bond energy means the energy required to break a covalent bond of a diatomic atoms which are in covalent bond and exist in gaseous state. Once again repeat, bond length means the energy required to break a covalent bond, of a diatomic molecule which is held in covalent bond and the atoms are exist in the gaseous state. So simply we can say the energy required to break a covalent bond is called as a bond energy. I think you understand about the bond length and bond energy. Generally, the bond length and bond energy, which is useful to predict the chemical properties of the molecule. If the molecule has the low bond energy and the high bond length, which is the active and which is the polar in nature. Once I repeat, if the molecule have condition one, low bond energy, high bond length, high bond length. Okay, Randy. Then which is the active? Active. And which is polar in nature? Nature. For example, iodine, which is containing a low bond energy and a high bond length, so which is the active, that means which is participated in the chemical reaction very actively. Here iodine bond energy is 151 kilojoule per mole. What is this? The bond energy of the iodine, and bond length of the iodine is 2.68 angstrom units. Here which is containing the bond energy is the low and bond length is the high. So this is the active. Next, coming to second condition, if the molecule have the high bond energy, comma, low bond length which is stable, that means which is not participated in reaction. Here, for example, hydrogen fluoride. If we take the hydrogen fluoride, the bond energy of hydrogen fluoride is 570 kilojoule per mole. And bond length is 0.918 angstrom units. So which is the stable, which is not participated in the reaction. Now comparison between these two. Here iodine bond energy is 151 kilojoule per mole. Here hydrogen fluoride bond energy is 570 kilojoule per mole. So here bond energy of the hydrogen fluoride molecule is more than the iodine, and here the bond length of the iodine is 2.68 angstrom units. The bond length of hydrogen fluoride is 0.918 angstrom units. So here which is having a low bond energy and high boiling point, high bond length, so which is the active? Which is having the high bond energy, low bond length, so which is the stable? I hope you all of you understand very well.